The daily hustle and bustle at work and of city life can take a toll on your health. And most of the time, even a high dose of vitamin C is not enough to boost your immune system. You need a multivitamin supplement that gives you maximum protection against diseases. You need Conzase, with vitamins A, C, E, and zinc that give you superior white blood cells. Conzase, for heavy-duty immunity.
The call for an honest and clean halal in 2013 begins now. Because our country's future lies in our hands, let's patrol the elections together. Bayan Mo Ipatrol Mo makes it easy for you to report violations in the election campaign rules through abs-cbnnews.com mobile app. Comelec Halalan 2013 mobile app. Online. Or through the BMPM hotline. It takes a nation to build a nation. Bayan Mo Ipatrol Mo. Tayo na.
Copy this morning, 10 years ago, singer Jed Madela only dreamt of making a name in Philippine entertainment. But after defying the impulse to join the pop craze, today Jed continues to stand out with his brand of music. Here's a look at a decade of Jed's flourishing career.
Starting out again is never easy.
10 years since Jed Madela broke into the entertainment industry, he admits it was a tough climb from being a virtual unknown to getting a following and making a name for his flawless singing and world-class performances. From his initial foray, it was just a matter of time before Universal Records discovered the balladeer and signed him up for a record deal. Although the release of his first album was not as successful as expected, it spawned an early hit via the single Let Me Love You. Since then, he sold thousands of records, reviving some of the most memorable ballads and all-time favorites. Known for a uniquely wide vocal range, Jed joined the Voice of Asia competition in 2003. He was voted People's Choice on finals night and won the attention of sponsors. 2 years later, he made waves by besting almost 3,000 contestants from 52 countries and was named Grand Champion of the World in a global competition for the performing arts. During the height of acoustic acts, he defied the odds by persisting with the classics. After a fruitful decade marked by his participation in mainstream entertainment, Jed is poised to expand his horizons in June by taking a step into the Southeast Asian market. He's also gearing up for a major concert and a new album. Thankful for the help he got in achieving his impossible dream, today Jed nurtures the dream of paying it forward by mentoring a new breed of talented and promising artists.
And joining us on Hot Copy, world-class performer Jed Madela is with us this morning.
Thank you for coming.
You were supposed to be our guest last week.
Yeah,
and now thank you for coming this week.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Okay. All right. Now, before we start the interview, I want you to start with a song.
Mm-hmm. What? Do you
any
have
song? Request? Let's do Les Mis.
Okay.
The title first.
I Dreamed a Dream.
But why do you sing I Dreamed a Dream? I mean, that's for women usually.
Well, probably because of the message of the song.
The message.
You know, everybody has a dream, and you know, we try to push and we try to really work hard to get that dream. Some may not
get it,
some may, but you know, what matters is, you know, you try.
Okay.
All right.
Sige nga.
I dream a dream in times gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving. And I was young and unafraid, when dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, no wine untasted. But the tigers come at night, with a voice as soft as thunder, as they tear your hopes apart and they turn your dream to shame.
My gosh, the original of I Dreamed a Dream must be, was it a soprano? I cannot tell.
I think it's
because
soprano.
They say they lowered the key for Anne Hathaway.
It's actually a very high song.
Yeah. Yeah, but then she did it very well. But you sing a soprano too?
I can reach it? I kind of reach it, yeah.
What is your vocal range?
Well, I'm a tenor, probably because I trained myself in a band where I had to sing everything from male songs to female songs.
Oh my gosh. I think I
stretched my range.
Yeah.
So sometimes I get to reach the soprano.
Now, you started singing when you were 5 years old, mm-hmm. and your father was your vocal coach.
Yes, yes.
Was there always a singer in the family?
Everybody sings. If not singing, somebody's playing the piano or playing the guitar or dancing.
Yeah.
So we basically come from a very musically inclined family.
Now, you graduated in business at one point. You wanted to be a flight attendant,
yes.
But now you're the very famous Jed Madela.
Yes, what's funny, because when I was in high school, I was already invited to join showbiz, but my dad didn't want me to get into showbiz. He wanted me to finish school, so he told me finish school first and then you can do whatever you want to do after college. But after college, I said, Dad, pwede na ba ako magkumanta? And he didn't like. He thought I would forget, because he said, being in showbiz is unstable.
Totoo naman yun.
Kung wala kang racket, you don't have money. I asked him, can I just, try it out for a year? And then during that year, sabi ko, if it doesn't work, I'll go back. I'll go to a normal job. And okay naman.
Did you have to join a series of contests like Sara Geronimo or Angeline Quinto? Or was it just a few big ones that already got you noticed?
Well, I only joined two. The first one was in 2003, The Voice of Asia in Kazakhstan. And the second big one, which I think would be the one that really boosted me up, was in 2005.
Yes.
The World Championships in Hollywood.
Which is the World Championship of the Performing Arts.
Yes.
Now, what's amazing is you single-handedly won all.
Yes, I did.
The major industry awards in that contest.
Mm-hmm.
All golds. How many did
All
you
gold.
Win?
I won 6 golds, gold medals.
Uh-oh.
I got Grand Champion Vocalist of the World, Grand Champion Performer of the World, which is the ultimate prize, and Uh-oh. 2 industry awards.
Buti buhay ka pang nakalabas sa contest na yun.
Oh, naman.
Kasi kung ibang contestant, baka patayin na kita.
Hindi kasi, I was the quiet one. Kumbaga, while the contest was going on, I was just in one corner. Hindi ako yung tipong Mr. Congeniality na nakikihalubilo. I was the quiet one. I was in one corner, just quiet, doing my rehearsing my songs, and they barely noticed me. So
yeah.
They just kind of noticed.
They were surprised.
Yeah, when I started singing.
Okay.
Yun na lang.
All right. Let's do a little look back, huh?
Mm-hmm.
For the pop category of the World Championship of the Performing Arts, these are all the songs wherein he won the gold. You sang just bits part of it, mm-hmm. okay? I'm Your Angel.
I'll be your cloud up in the sky. I'll be your shoulder when you cry. I'll hear your voices when you call me. I am your angel.
My God! All right. Now, for the original song category, meaning that's a composition from the singer's home country, you mm-hmm. sang Martin Rivera's old hit, Be My Lady.
Yes,
you
I
won
did.
The gold, too.
Yes. Be my lady, let the sun shine through your heart and make a brand new start. Stay with me each night and day through the rest of my life, just like a work of art. My love will last until forever.
Oh my God. Now you know what Martin Rivera said about you, right?
Yeah.
I mean, of course he really admires you but hates you at the same time.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. But Martin is one of those who influenced me a lot. I grew up singing all his songs.
Yeah.
I even remember, you know, I inipon ko yung allowance ko just to buy his cassette tape.
Yeah.
Before.
So. Do you have it? Do you have it, Arlene? Because I remember, unless it's rolled, but Martin Yevera said something like, you sang so well that I actually hate it. that, you know what I mean, when he's with you. But to be fair to Martin Yevera, I would have to say that in he has the best male voice, the quality.
Exactly.
Yeah. Exactly. And then you would be either at par or in competition. You get me?
Nah, Martin's here. I'm lower.
Okay, all right. That's sweet. Now, you also sang for the Broadway category, Home.
Yes.
What song is that? When I Think of Home?
When I Think of Home.
Okay, go ahead.
I think of a place where there's love overflowing. I wish I was home. I wish I was back there. But things I've been knowing.
In fairness. And the pop duet category with Risa Navalis. You sang Last Night of the World. This is hard.
Yes, it
that's
is.
That's hard.
Yeah.
Okay, but you that's very high.
Yeah, it was. It is, actually. It goes like... in a place that won't let us feel. In a life where nothing seems real. I have found you. I have found you. And then the girl goes, in a world that's moving too fast. In a world where nothing can last. I will hold you. I will hold you.
There. Oh my gosh. All right. And then for gospel, you sang Take Me Out of the Dark by Gary Valenciano.
I did.
Okay. Yeah.
Take me out of the dark, my Lord, 'cause I don't want to be alone. Take me out of the dark, my Lord, I don't want to be there.
Ooh. My gosh! Lahat ata ng kanta kaya mo? Ano ba to? And the song that made you the grand champion. Would you believe it, everyone? He sang Aerosmith's I Don't Want to Miss a Thing, which, by the way, they asked Jessica Sanchez to sing in American Idol, and that got like mixed reviews, huh? But Aerosmith himself, I mean, what's the name of the
Steven
guy?
Steven Tyler.
Steven Tyler said that she sang it so well, but I want to hear your version of I Don't Want to Miss a Thing.
All right. I don't want to close my eyes. I don't want to fall asleep because I'll miss you, babe. And I don't want to miss a thing. Because even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream would never do. I'd still miss you, babe. And I don't want to miss a thing.
My fairness. How do you, did you have a vocal training?
No, I didn't. Nothing? Any formal training. It was just my dad.
But now do you train? I mean, you know what happened to Adele.
I know.
I mean, that's like a natural gifted voice, and then suddenly it was damaged with no training.
Well, I think everybody needs training, but it all boils down to discipline.
Okay.
Especially if you're a singer. As much as possible, you have to avoid all, you know, things.
So you don't drink wine?
I drink occasionally, but not so much.
You don't smoke,
I don't
of course.
Smoke.
That's a given.
And as
you
much as possible, I try to get some sleep.
Yeah, because the secret with the vocal cords is really sleeping early.
Yes, it's rest.
Yeah, which
and lots of water.
Lots of water, yeah. I just have to make up with a lots of water because, yung pagpuyat ka and then you wake up early, that's hard for singing.
And it dries your throat. And once your throat is dry and you start using it, it gets gas.
Now, do you always you want a niche in singing, or do you at some point want to also go into acting?
Well, there have been offers since that's like the trend now that everybody tries out everything. Like my co-champions, Eric Christian, and everybody else have tried out acting. There have been offers, but I don't know yet. I think it takes the right timing for me, because
you are very good looking.
Wow, thank you.
Yeah, guapo ka.
Thank you. But probably the right project and the right guidance.
Okay.
Yeah, because I tend to be very conscious when I'm on cam.
Yeah. Now, I've also noticed that you've lost a lot of weight, which is a great thing.
Yeah.
Does it affect, singing?
It does. It does.
When a person is fit, I mean, I'm curious because some of the opera singers are quite hefty.
Yes, they are.
So I'm thinking that it doesn't really matter that much.
Well, it depends. Yung, kumbaga, they sometimes they have this term, sa laki ng kaha.
Oh, yun.
Yeah,
yun.
It becomes more solid. It becomes more compact, more powerful compared to skinny singers.
Yes, yes.
That although they can reach the high notes, it's a bit shrill, a bit manipis.
Pero totoo yun.
Yeah, yeah. The size works, but
the size works.
Yeah, it actually affects the quality of the voice.
Yeah.
But you know what's dangerous is when you're kind of on the heavy side and you suddenly lose weight, it
affects the voice.
Affects the voice.
Really?
Yes, yes.
So what have you been doing?
Well, I've been slowly trying to lose weight.
You look great. So you're dieting?
Yes, dieting,
going
to the gym. Yeah,
yeah.
I try to go to the gym. One important thing that, you know, that really made me decide to go back to the gym is one day I did a concert and after the entire show, I lost my breath. Parang hinihingal ako. Parang siguro hindi na sanay na you know, I've been performing for before when I was, you know, a bit younger, for 3 hours straight, and it didn't matter. But of course, you have to train yourself na, lalo na ngayon, na before sa banda kasi, I'd sing everything. But now, I only get to sing like one song, two songs, three songs. Parang naging lax yung lung power. So one concert, I really, you know, felt the effort. I really felt the strain. Yeah.
Oh, exhausted.
Exhausted. After the show, I collapsed in the dressing room.
You're serious?
Yeah. And then, it was kind of difficult to sing. Kasi hinihingal ka, diba? So I really pushed myself to go back.
No,
to
but
the
that's a very good point. It makes sense because people think that working out is just to look good. But it actually gives you endurance and strength.
That's
because
right.
I watched Jennifer Lopez's concert and I was thinking that's a freaking tour. And she was like dancing
the
for
entire
like
time.
3 hours,
yeah.
Diba?
That's right. It really helps when, kahit na ano, you don't have to have your trainer, you don't have to have somebody who's gonna train you with the weights and all. All you have to do is just go on a treadmill and run. And if you have a treadmill in the house and you're a singer, try running and singing at the same time.
Oh my God, I think Madonna tried that. I don't know if her vocal range improved though. Okay, now give me a song that you feel is the story of your life.
Well, I think I Don't Wanna Miss a Thing.
Really?
I Don't Wanna Miss a Thing. Well, if you listen to the song, it sounds like a love song. It is a love song, but the words really hit me most because I enjoy each and every moment that is happening right now.
Okay.
Especially that I did not plan this.
Uh-oh.
The original plan was for me to become a flight attendant.
Uh-oh.
And although I loved singing, it never occurred to me to make it as my career.
Mm-mm.
So every time I get on stage, every show that I do, every person that I, you know, touch with my music, with my songs, it's a big deal for me. So every moment na may lumapit lang sa akin na, Jed, you know, this song really, your song really affected me. It's my favorite. It's a big thing. You know, more than all those awards, it's more of
The impact.
The impact I do, give to people.
Now, what about your parents? Are you still close to them?
Yes, very close. Very
your
close.
Mom and dad?
Yeah,
so you're okay.
I'm close to my mom and dad, and actually my dad just celebrated his birthday yesterday.
How old is he?
He's 59.
Okay,
pretty
that's young.
Yeah, so dad, happy birthday. Well, I'm very thankful that they instilled so much values in us, not just sa akin, but with my brother and my sister. Na, you know, we make it the point that we stay grounded, especially me. Now, sometimes when you're in this business, sometimes you forget. Sometimes the popularity, the fame, and whatever can get into your head, and sometimes you forget your roots and your values. But I'm very happy that my dad and mom always has the time to call me and you know, remind me. And they and ako naman, I make it a point that once. Whenever I can, I go home and go back to the normal Jed.
Do they still live in Iloilo?
Yes, they do.
Where in Iloilo? I'm from Iloilo. My dad is.
They live in Molo.
Ah, okay. Molo. All right. What is your song to your parents?
Well, actually, ano ba? They have this song. Actually, they have this song na sa kanila to their love song that I recorded in one of my albums. It's their theme song. It's called Let Me Try Again.
Okay.
Yeah, it's...
Why? Munti kang ba silang naghiwalay?
Yeah, kasi my mom's a nurse.
Okay.
And ano sila? High school sweethearts.
Uh-oh.
From high school until college. And when my mom graduated, she wanted to leave for the States.
Mm-hmm. So baka munti kang mag-break.
Oo, so my dad... Ayaw niya, but my mom was really serious in pursuing her nursing career. But then my dad really pushed, and you know, hindi na, she gave up nursing and mm-hmm. she didn't leave, and then she married my dad.
Okay.
So ayan, kami.
What's the song? Go before we go to a break.
I know I said that I was leaving, but I just couldn't say goodbye. It was only self-deceiving to walk away from someone who means everything in life to you. You learn from every passing day. I've learned and I've come back to stay.
Fairness. Ganun. Ganda. All right, we'll take a quick break. When we return, Jed Madela will still be singing for all of you. Hot Copy will be right back. All right, welcome back to Hot Copy. With us is great balladeer Jed Madela, and he'll be having a concert actually February 14.
February 14. It's called Beyond Expectations. It's a spin-off of my concert at the Cultural Center last year, and it's going to be in Dagupan. February 14 at the CSI Stadia, 8:30 p.m. And my special guest here is Kit Kat.
Ah, nice.
Yeah.
And what's amazing is Jed is the first Filipino to be awarded the Hall of Famer for the World Championships of Performing Arts this coming July.
Yeah.
How major is that?
Well, it's the World Championships. Every year they give honor to people in the business, and for the past years they've honored, you know, icons like Liza Minnelli, Dionne Warwick, and the guy.
They have?
Yeah, they did.
Wag ganung level ka.
Oh nga, eh, nagulat
niya. Oh my God, Liza Minnelli level.
Yeah, and like Jacqueline Smith.
Wow.
Yeah, and
but she can sing.
Well, not just singers, but
even acting.
People
in the
showbiz industry. Yeah, and even like our co-Filipino. His name's, well, he's American, but his name is Michael Copon.
Okay.
He was here a few years back, and also the guy from Cirque du Soleil. I think they're awarding him this year together with me. So when I got the news about, you know, the award, I was stunned. I didn't know what to say, because you know, they just told me a few months back. So,
is there anything you want to do, like you really dream of doing?
Well, I think I would like to put up my own music school
in the Philippines.
In the Philippines,
okay.
Yeah.
But that will be much later on. Mm-hmm. But in terms of performing, do you want to do Broadway?
I would like to try Broadway.
But then, of course, you'd have to quit ASAP for a while. That's just the thing.
I know. But when I won in 2005, actually, there were offers already for work in the States. But the requirement was for me to leave the country.
You have to live there.
Yeah, I have to live there and leave the Philippines. But I just signed, during that time, I just signed up with Universal. And I was promoting the album. And I just got into ASAP. And I couldn't just turn back. So, but I'm happy now that the offers are still there, and hopefully in July when I go back to the States.
You want to join any other, like, for example, I mean, what other than American Idol?
No more competitions for me. Probably as a mentor or as a judge, probably.
Are you a mentor for The Voice here?
Is that
the show, The Voice?
Yeah, it's a show. It's a competition. It's
in the Philippines.
In the Philippines, we have The Voice. Yes, it started in the States, and why not, diba?
You should mentor.
Sana nga eh, sana. I don't know yet. There are no invites yet.
Ma'am Charo, I think you should invite Jed Madela as the mentor.
I'd love to.
She loves Head Start. She watches every morning.
Hi, Ma'am Charo.
Okay. All right. Now, Adele is one of my favorites. Mm-hmm. And you said, this is the song Jed asked for him to sing Adele. Rolling in the Deep.
All right. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fevered pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare. See how I leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fevered pitch and it's bringing me out the dark. We could have had it all, rolling in the deep. You had my heart inside your hand and you played it to the beat.
My God! My God, pwede ka makipag-duet kay Adele.
Oh,
now, do you have rituals? You know, it was interesting. I have a concert of Adele, the DVD. Mm-hmm. And I saw at one point, she was singing nakayapak on stage. Like, she took off her shoes mm-hmm. and sang barefoot. So, I mean, it must have some feeling. I was saying that.
Yeah, it's comfortable.
But what about you?
Ako naman, wala. I don't have any stage rituals. It's more of... It's unconsciously I give 3 long deep breaths before I go on stage.
Yeah.
Parang naging ano ko na yun na parang.
Okay.
3 times.
Do you pray?
I do.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Do you drink anything?
As much as possible, I drink less. Like I don't take any so much liquid before the show because
yeah.
I sweat a lot.
Yeah.
And during the usually my concert lasts like 2 hours, 3 hours. The entire show, I never drink water.
You don't drink water
Weird.
The entire show?
No, I don't.
Oh my God, kasi, what do you drink in between?
Wala. I don't.
I cannot believe.
It's difficult
Are
kasi
you
for
serious?
Me. Kasi, ano, when I drink, I have this tendency to burp a lot.
Okay.
So it doesn't sound good if you sing and then suddenly you just burp.
I was just going to say that Regine Velasquez recently had a concert mm-hmm. and I was following it on Twitter. And so many singers were actually, of course, her heart was reaching out to her. Mm-hmm. Even me, of course.
Yes.
That there was one concert wherein she couldn't sing and
yes,
she had lost
there.
Her voice. You were there.
I was there.
And that must be so painful to see as a singer.
Yeah, it is. I was crying, actually. I was crying.
You were crying, yeah.
Yeah. I felt so bad because I know how it feels. I experienced that in one concert in Cebu.
Okay.
That the day before, I was already... You know, totally, I didn't
Parang
have any voice.
Hirap na.
Yeah, and sabi ko, hindi, babalik to bukas. I was just, you know, trying to, you know, think positive. And on the day of the concert, like, hapon, the afternoon, wala talaga.
Yeah.
So I had to ask for help from a doctor. And
probably gave you steroids.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. And then during the concert, first few songs, I was having difficulty. I couldn't sing.
Oh,
so
wow.
I know how it feels.
Yeah.
And sobrang sakit. You know, eventually, during the middle part of the concert, lumabas na yung boses ko. But after the concert, wala. It was gone again.
Okay. Now, Jaja Padilla, even before, I think the doctor had asked her to have voice rest.
Yes.
I think for a month or
you
something.
You need to, actually.
Yeah, I need to.
yeah, especially
but then
with...
Yeah, I talk too much.
Yeah, it's more taxing, actually. Talking is more stressful compared to singing.
Agree.
Yes, it is. It is.
Because there's just so much air coming in and out.
Yeah.
And then you're not really speaking from your diaphragm naman when you're making kwento.
That's right. May placement kasi.
Uh-oh.
So, you need to rest. You really need to rest. If you can, like voice rest for a month. But which is, that's impossible for us. Cause
I know.
Yeah, work is really, you know, every day. As much as possible, if you find time, try to rest.
Okay. All right. Another singer I love, Josh Groban.
Mm-hmm. Sige.
Okay.
I'll change my placement.
You can.
Yeah.
And then you told me that people people ask you to copy singers.
Yeah,
I'll ask you later on if you want to.
Sige, sige.
Okay, but like Josh Groban.
Mm. Erase me up so I can stand on mountains. Erase me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Erase me up to more than I can be.
I really like that pitch, that style.
Yeah.
I noticed that you can do any style.
Yeah.
But is that also a weakness? I mean, now, for me, that you can do such a wide range of styles,
mm-hmm.
the question is, will you be remembered for you?
Yeah, actually,
I'm curious.
That's one of my difficulties. People notice me because of my high notes. And sometimes if I try to sing, you know, songs that are, you know, relaxed lang,
they parang kind of are like, okay, magaling. But when I hit the high notes, that's the time that they you know, really shout and, yeah, and react.
But I like the Josh Groban.
Yeah, so
yeah, it's very high and very male
and very solid.
Very,
yeah,
solid.
And it's not that painful to the throat. Yeah, because it's going to be difficult because people will be confused. Ano ba talaga yung singing style mo? Ganon.
What about you? Who is Jed Madela talaga?
Well, ako, the high notes. The high notes will always be there. And big ballads, big powerful ballads.
Okay.
Yun talaga yung Jed Madela.
When they ask you to copy some singers, I'll tell me if these are the people they ask. I mean, Whitney Houston?
Yeah, they do.
Okay, give me a line.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. Tapos they make me hit the high notes.
Okay.
And I will always love you.
Oh my God! Akaloka! Ano yun? Okay, Celine Dion.
Ah, Celine
I'm
Dion.
Sure these are the things they ask. I'm thinking what they ask.
Near, far, wherever you are, I believe that the others go on.
You really sound like Barbara Streisand.
Ah. Barbara Streisand.
Not the dance song, ha? Choke.
Love,
anak ko yun eh.
Love, soft as an easy chair. Love, fresh as the morning air. One love. Yun.
Sino pa inaas?
Sino pa ba?
Even Lani Misalucha so good at that. No?
Yeah, they make me do Lani sometimes.
Yeah, Lani.
Bukas na lang kita mamahali sabay sa paglaya ng ating mga puso.
My God, you are insanely gifted. Really. Do you ever fear losing your voice?
Oh, yeah.
I can imagine.
I do. Sometimes when I get, sore throat, I'm like, oh, my God.
Uh-oh. Medyo ganito ka na, Lord, please. Lord, in please. Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Because I can imagine the range that you can sing. If you were not a singer, what would you be doing?
I'd probably be running a restaurant.
Okay, yeah. So you cook.
I cook, yeah, I do.
Okay, and men that cook are sexy.
Wow.
Well, I can't cook at all. But then there, Julius Babao cooks.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he loves them. So you cook.
I do.
What
do
you cook?
I cook everything, like real food, not those diet foods.
Serious?
Yeah, my specialty is Korean beef stew.
Okay.
That, you know, all my friends, they always ask me to bring food, Korean beef stew, especially my friends from Star Magic. One time I brought this big pot of 7 kilos of beef.
Okay.
Beef stew, and then, you know, in just a snap, wala na, ubos.
Uh-oh. All right, I'm curious, will you ever get married?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd like to have my own family, especially now that my brother and my sister, they're both married, and my brother has a kid already. My sister is expecting in April. Nakakaingit. Narang may mga anak na sila, may mga, you know, they have their own lives. In the future, I'd like to have my own family.
Mm. Because is it difficult at some point that in the Philippines, I mean, it's not like abroad where they can be stars and not have their personal lives as part of it. Like, you have actors where you don't really know their personal lives.
Yes.
I mean, like Kevin Spacey or great actors, where in Marlon Brando, you have no idea what their lives
That's
are.
Right.
But here in the Philippines, you know.
Everything. Pati size ng underwear mo,
exactly.
Alam nila.
Exactly. I mean, do you want to have that kind of stardom?
So at some point, it's nice to have that, but ako personally, I'm a very private person. That's why I remain like the underdog when it comes to all the champions in ASAP. Na, you know, everybody knows about what they're doing. Ako naman, when I'm on TV, that's the time they just see me.
Okay.
And when it's my personal life, like my family, and I keep it private.
Okay. All right. We don't have enough time, but you do have to think of a major song as we close the show. But February 14, please don't forget, Jed will be in the Gupan. Yes. That's a major concert. So if you're anywhere in that area. And also, Jed is coming up with his new CD. It's yes. all original. Tinan mo, kabisado ko.
All original.
Okay, when is that coming out?
It's coming out anytime soon, like before Valentine's.
Okay.
And it's 10 tracks of original songs.
Yes.
Finally, I get to sing original songs.
Yes, and Garlic Garcia of yes. ASAP, would you believe everyone, actually wrote one of Jed Madela's songs.
Ms. G, it's track number one.
Oh, in fairness
it's
to
track
Garlic.
Number one.
All
yeah.
right, and you do have CDs right now that's out in the market.
That's right.
Okay,
yes,
Breathe Again?
Breathe Again is my latest.
Okay,
album.
All right. Breathe Again is your latest. But is that the cover of Breathe Again?
No, it's an original song.
It's also an yeah. original. Okay, so Jed Madela, thank you. Wait, what are you closing
thank
the
you.
Show with?
Well, I'm singing. This song that I it's my strength song.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
I love this song and
right.
whenever I'm down I always sing this song.
Okay. So that's yet to start today. Replay of Jed Madela's interview is at 6 p.m. tonight. Have a good weekend, everyone. On Monday we'll be having Jack and Rile on ANC Head Start. We're closing the show with Jed Madela. Thank you, Jed.
Thank you. They don't know that I come running home when I fall down. They don't know who picks me up when no one is around. I drop my sword and cry for just a while. 'Cause deep inside this summer, deep inside these armor, deep inside this summer, the warrior is a child.